Rodney James Alcala was born on August 23, 1943, in San Antonio, Texas. After his father abandoned the family, his mother moved them to Los Angeles in 1954 when he was 11 years old. At the age of 17, Alcala joined the Army as a clerk, but had a nervous breakdown and was discharged on medical grounds. He then went to UCLA's School of Fine Arts. Alcala's first known victim was 8-year-old Tali Shapiro, whom he kidnapped, raped, and beat in his apartment in 1968. Thankfully, she survived and received 27 stitches in her head from the blows Alcala inflicted on her using a steel bar. Alcala fled to New York under the name John Berger and was able to evade arrest for a few years. When he was extradited back to California by the FBI in 1971, Shapiro's family refused to allow her to testify at his trial and moved to Mexico. Their case now severely weakened, prosecutors charged Alcala with assault. He was released after only 17 months but was back in jail after assaulting a 13-year-old girl. Once again, Alcala was paroled shortly thereafter and was back on the streets. During this time, Alcala traveled to New York and killed Ellen Jane Hover. She was 23 at the time and happened to be the goddaughter of Dean Martin and Sammy Davis Jr. Alcala presented himself to the world as a professional photographer and used his purported job to capture the images of countless people for his portfolio. He had taken over 1,000 photos of women, girls, and boys, some in very sexually explicit positions. In the hope of identifying more victims, 120 photos were released to the public by the police. This photo of Christine Thornton was one that was publicized. Her body was found in Wyoming in 1982. She was 6 months pregnant at the time and disappeared in 1977 after a breakup with her boyfriend. Christine's sister had spent almost 40 years looking for her after losing touch and identified her sister's photo in 2013. An MO of Alcala was he wouldn't kill his victims right away. Instead, he would choke them or strangle them with stockings until they lost consciousness and wait for them to come to. He would do this repeatedly before killing them. Notably, Alcala made an appearance on The Dating Game, a very popular show at the time where a bachelorette would choose one of three bachelors without seeing them based on a series of questions she would pose.
I'm called the banana, and I look really good.
One of the other contestants had this to say about Alcala.
He was a real creepy guy, a real idiot. This creep comes up and he puts his face practically in my face and he says, I always get when I think about what he said, I always get my girl, he kills him. That's what he's talking about.
Alcala put on the charm and actually was the winner of the episode filmed 10 months prior to its airing. But because bachelorette Cheryl Bradshaw, with whom he was to go on the date, found him creepy and weird backstage, the date never happened. Lucky for her, as she could have easily become one of his next victims. As a result of his TV appearance, Alcala is often aptly referred to as the Dating Game Killer. When the episode aired in September 1978, he had already murdered 5 women. Less than a year after the program, Alcala was finally charged with murder. In 1979, friends of Robin Sasso, aged 12, told police a strange man approached them at the beach and asked to take their photos. Robin later left on her bike, and 12 days later, her decomposing body was found in the foothills of Los Angeles. After searching Alcala's apartment and finding a rental receipt for his storage locker, Robin's earrings were located there. Alcala was taken into custody and was later sentenced to death for Robin's murder. However, because the jurors had been improperly told of Alcala's prior sex crimes, the verdict was overturned. In 1986, he was tried, convicted, and sentenced to death once again, but a court of appeals nullified the conviction on another technicality. Leading up to Alcala's third trial in 2003, his DNA also linked him to 4 additional females: Jill Barcombe, age 18 in Los Angeles in 1977, Georgia Wickstead, age 27 in Malibu in 1977, Charlotte Lamb, age 31, in El Segundo in 1978, and Jill Parenteau, age 21, in Burbank in 1979. Another pair of earrings belonging to one of those women was found in Alcala's storage locker. In February 2010, Alcala's third trial commenced, and he represented himself. He subjected the courtroom to a self-interrogation on the stand for 5 hours, using different voices when he would ask the questions and then answer them. He also blew kisses to the mother of one of his victims. Another oddity of the trial was during closing arguments when Alcala played the portion of a song by Arlo Guthrie called Alice's Restaurant. In it, the singer tells a psychiatrist that he wants to kill, kill, kill. The jury deliberated for less than 2 days before coming back with the guilty verdicts of first-degree murder for 5 of Alcala's victims. During the penalty phase, Alcala's first known victim, Tali Shapiro, whose family did not allow her to testify at his first trial, made a surprise appearance. It took the jury less than a few hours to reach their sentencing verdict. Alcala had dared the jury to give him the death penalty, and they obliged. In March 2010, Alcala was sentenced to death for the third time in California for 5 murders committed between 1977 and 1979. He was sentenced to an additional 25 years to life after pleading guilty to 2 other homicides he committed in New York in 1971 and 1977. He has been linked to over 130 victims. Alcala has often been compared to Ted Bundy. Depending on who you ask, they were both very charming and seemingly normal, some may even say attractive, but undoubtedly they were both sexual sadists who raped and murdered multiple victims. They both represented themselves at trial, and they were both sentenced to death. But unlike Bundy, Alcala's execution would never take place. He died of natural causes on July 24, 2021, while on death row. He was 77 years old.